PBC is starting their Amazon Prime thing.
Oh, I saw. I think Tejas might be there.
What?
So the psychic says we're going to have an earthquake in March? What if they're wrong?
We're having March, I'll tell you right now.
Yeah. I don't know, I trust the psychics.
It's very tornado in February. We're going to have a big tornado in Atlanta and in Houston. Yeah.
What if it's 20. Robert, what if it's just a sponsored segment?
We're going to have a sandstorm for like a month.
It's a sponsored segment by people who make sandbags and water supplies and emergency kits.
That's true. Yeah, I don't believe in shit like that, but...
But listen, Mark, PBC are launching. Who are you looking forward to see? Like, who should Canelo fight, Robert?
I think he should fight Benavides, but I don't know if we're going to see it. But he should fight Benavides, 100%.
If it doesn't happen, who does he fight?
Canelo, maybe Charlo, 160.
Charlo. Does he win?
Charlo, Canelo knocks him out.
Charlo Canelo, Pita?
What happened?
Charlo Canelo, the other brother?
Charlo Canelo.
What about Benavides? Who does he fight? He wants Bivol, Beterbiev.
Benavides, Bivol, or fucking the Cuban. What's his name?
Dave Morrell.
Yeah, that's going to be a bad one.
So Bivol signed this part of the contract to fight Beterbiev. Now Beterbiev is fighting Smith.
Badass. They're going to have an undisputed.
That's good.
Tired. Yeah, Bivol is, you know, Bivol is one of those guys, man. Fuck, man, you know that. It's hard to be, because he just, boom, he gives you on the outside, kind of like if you're fighting a little, like with a sword and, you know, like
fencing, yeah.
First, you know, shit like that.
But he's really good at it.
He's good at it.
How do you beat a guy like that?
Can't beat him. You have to, and I don't know if Beterbiev is the one, because the Beterbiev has got power.
Yeah, very flat-footed, though. He's not going to.
I don't know, he's going to be fucking rushing him. That's the only way that you can fucking probably beat him. Before. You rush him and you hurt him and you fucking hurt him bad where... No, he's very smart. But Beterbiev doesn't fight like that either. He's a very good one.
He's getting older too. I don't know how old he is.
I think Bivol.
Me too.
Become undisputed.
That would be massive.
I think Bivol becomes undisputed. It's badass, you know, because right now there's so much undisputed and all that. People are willing to fight each other. People are willing to unify. You know, that doesn't happen after, bro. And right now, this year, these last couple of years have been good when it comes
Inui
to
was
unifying, becoming undisputed.
Crawford undisputed, yeah.
That's just badass.
But that's my thing. So don't trash a fighter when they take a big risk and don't win. Because we want to see the big... Yeah, they can take the easy route,
yeah.
But it's not the fights we want.
Loma took that loss against Devin Haney, but he's going to fight for the world title next.
Yeah. Who wins? Him and Kambosos.
He beats Kambosos. I don't think it's going to be easy, especially fighting in Kambosos' hometown.
Jeff Horn style.
He's going to fight against the judge. But I think Loma...
There's levels.
Pretty easy. Yeah, there's levels.
Loma's a fighter once in a generation.
Yeah.
But I don't want to see him fight too much, Robert.
Yeah,
because then...
Because he's already up there in age. And I don't want to see him end up getting hurt and getting beat up pretty bad.
Yeah, and then they take away from all his achievements.
You know, I don't know if how true that is. You know, obviously, but just word out there that he was already thinking of maybe not even fighting anymore, retiring. So one thing that I think him and his team seen and you know, you're fighting for the vacant world title against Kambosos, become champion and maybe retire as a champion. Or become champion and get a huge fight, make a few million dollars, and then retire.
Shakur,
yeah, something like that. And that's a possibility in Loma because I'm telling you, word was that he might not even want to fight this fight because he wants to retire. So maybe, look, become champion and retire as a champion.
After the fight with Haney, they said they were going to appeal it and do all that. Whatever happened with
that?
Can't
do that.
Why?
Even if you do, you know, because it was a pretty close fight, too. It wasn't like it was a really fucking robbery, you know, of the century, shit like that. They shouldn't look. Fucking Rollie's fight, Rollie didn't land one punch and the ref still stopped it. And they couldn't even appeal that one either. You know what I mean? Because the ref said, man, I seen that he was hurt. I thought he was hurt, so I stopped it. And, you know, but then that's when Nevada has instant replay. How come they didn't use instant replay in that fight? They could say, okay, don't take off your gloves. Let's go. Nothing happened. Let's continue fighting. That's what they should have done. But they didn't. You know, and Nevada has instant replay. So why did they do it? It's just politics. It's just the way boxing is.